better than that. Name of the Lord. For the name of the Lord is a strong tower where the righteous run in and they are safe. How many came to lift up the name of Jesus today? That's what we came to do. We came to lift the name of Jesus. We lift his name on high as we prepare. Amen. The song says, Lord, I lift your name on high. Lord, I love to sing your praises. I'm so glad you're in my life. And I'm so glad you came to save us. Hallelujah.
Show the way from the earth. to celebrate.
Lord, I lift your name on high. Lord, I lift your name on high. Lord, I lift your name on high.
One more time, one more time. Lord, I lift.
Lord, I lift your name on high.
You came from heaven to earth. To show us all the way, and from the earth to the cross, my simple daddy babe, from the cross to the grave, from the grave to the sky.
What are we coming to do?
Lord, I lift your name on high.
So we lift him up. So we lift him up. So we lift him up. Glory to his name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Father. Thank you. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Eternal God, our Lord and Savior. Lord, we thank you, Father, for this Resurrection Sunday, oh God. We thank you, Lord, for sacrificing your Son, Jesus, for our sins, oh God. We thank you, Lord, for all you have done, oh God. Lord, we wouldn't have made it this far without you, oh God. We thank you, Father, for bringing us to the throne of grace one more time, oh God. We thank you, Lord, for watching over us and our families, oh God. Lord, how you kept us from danger, seen and unseen, oh Lord. In the mighty name of Jesus, oh God. Lord, you've been better to us than we've been to ourselves, oh God. So we give you thanks, oh Lord. And we give you glory, oh Lord. On this blessed day, we say thank you, Lord.
Thank you,
Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. You're worthy to be praised. In the mighty name of Jesus, oh Lord. In your blessed name, oh God. We're calling on you, Lord. We're calling on you, Lord. We need you, Lord. In all aspects of our life, oh God. Lord, we can't do it without you, Lord. So, Lord, we say thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord, in the name of Jesus, oh God. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Lord, you watched over us, oh God. Lord, this triumph, Father God, that you allow your Son to go through was for us in the sin. Lord, we thank you for the blood that he shed, oh God. In the name of Jesus, oh Lord. In the mighty name of Jesus, oh Lord. So, Lord, we celebrate this time of commemoration for your Son in the mighty name of Jesus. Now, Lord, look upon those, Father God, that have not seen the righteousness yet, Lord. Lord, we ask you to direct them, Father God, to the throne of grace, oh Lord. Lord, bless them, Father God. Bless those who are sick right now, those who are in hospitals, oh God, those who are incarcerated, oh God. Lord, you're a forgiving God. And Lord, you're a miracle worker, Father. We say thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Bless God. Bless in the name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus, oh Lord. Saved by your grace and your mercy, oh Lord. Hallelujah. Now, Lord, bless the service as we go forth today. Look upon, Father God, our pastor and the first lady. Lord, touch their hearts, Father God. We thank you, Lord, for their service, oh God. We thank you, Lord, for what you're doing, Lord, with this temple, Lord. How you allow us, Father God, to be educated, Lord. And Lord, that you give us knowledge and wisdom, oh God. We thank you, Lord, for all the things you're doing, oh God. We ask, Lord, to bless, Father God, all the musicians, oh God. All those, Father God, who are here today, God, who came out, oh Lord, in spite of, oh God, they pressed their way, oh Lord, in the mighty name of Jesus, oh God. In your mighty name, oh Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Glory to your blessed name. Thank you, Lord. 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 In the name of Jesus, Lord. In your mighty name, oh God. Now, Lord, let your word go forth, oh God. That we not leave here the same way we came in, oh God. That you anoint the speaker today, Father. In Jesus' name we pray. Thank God and amen. Amen.
Word of the Lord this morning comes from Psalms 34,
verses 4 through 10. And the word of the Lord says, I sought the Lord, and he heard me, and he delivered me from all my fears. They looked unto him and were lightened, and their faces were not ashamed. This poor man cried, and the Lord heard him, and saved him out of all his troubles. The angel of the Lord encampeth round about them that fear him, and delivereth them. Oh, taste and see that the Lord is good. Blessed is the man that trusteth in him. Oh, fear the Lord, ye his saints, for there is no want to them that fear him. The young lions do lack and suffer hunger, but they that seek the Lord shall not want any good thing. Hear ye the word of the Lord. Amen.
Can we praise the God of our salvation? Come on. Let's praise the God of our salvation. Come on, let's praise the God of our salvation. As we are celebrating the resurrection of our Lord and Savior, you know, we are a church that we have young people, we have older people, we have everybody in between. And whereas we sing all kinds of, whether it's old hymns, traditional, it's Resurrection Sunday. And on today, we're going to sing an old, For He is Lord. For He is Lord. He has risen from the dead, and He is Lord. Every knee shall bow. Every knee shall bow. And every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is Lord.
Let's sing it again. Those of you that know He's Lord, let's stand.
For He is Lord.
Oh, for He
is Lord.
He has risen from the dead.
He has risen from the dead. And He is Lord.
Every knee shall bow.
Every knee shall bow. Every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is Lord.
Let's do it with no music. Let's do it with no music. Lift your voice.
For He is Lord.
Raise your voice and say, For He.
For He is Lord.
He has risen from the dead.
He has risen from the dead. And He is Lord.
Every knee shall bow.
Every knee shall bow.
Come on, let's say, I love you.
I love you, Jesus.
I worship and adore you.
I worship and adore you.
Just want to tell you.
Just want to tell you.
Lord, I love you.
Lord, I love you.
More than anything.
More than anything.
Can we say it again? I love you, Jesus. I love you, Jesus. I love you, Jesus.
I love you, Jesus.
I worship and adore you.
I worship and adore you.
Just want to tell you.
Just want to tell you.
Lord, I love you.
Lord, I love you.
Yeah.
More than anything.
Yeah. Lift your voice and say, oh, I love you, Jesus. I love you, Jesus. I love you, Jesus.
I love you, Jesus.
And adore you.
I worship and adore you.
I just want to tell you.
Just want to tell you.
Lord, I love you.
Lord, I love you.
Oh.
More than anything.
Oh, I love you. I love you. I love you. I love you. Come on, raise your voice. Say, I love you.
I love you, Jesus.
I worship and adore you.
I worship and adore you.
Just want to tell you.
Just want to tell you.
That I love you.
Lord, I love you. More than anything.
No music, no background. Let me hear the congregation say, oh, I love you, Jesus. Say, I love you. I worship and adore you. Just want to tell you. Lord, I love you. One more time. I love you, Jesus. I love you, Jesus. Help me say, I love you.
I love you, Jesus.
I worship and adore you, Jesus.
I worship and adore you.
Just want to tell you.
Just want to tell you.
Lord, I love you.
Lord, I love you. More than anything.
Now let's clap our hands and praise our God. Our God is great. Our God is worthy. Our God is awesome. He is risen with all power. And if he's your God and you love him, if he's your God and you serve him, can you just clap your hands and open up your mouth and love on him? Love on him. Love on him. Hallelujah. Love on him. Love on him.
the sins of the world. He bowed his head and he died.
Jesus has risen, Jesus our friend. Joy fills our heart, and he lives again.
Let's give our brother Jace a hand. Come on, we can do better than that. He learned that, and he said that with confidence. And then let's give our liturgical ministry a hand. No, come on. Come on, give them a hand. Glory. Under the leadership of our sister Jamila, assisted by our sister Shasta, our young ladies, our ladies, they did a wonderful job ministering about the death, burial, and resurrection of our Lord and Savior. Amen. Amen. We're preparing a final worship song, and then we're going to the Word of God. How many glad that God got up? Y'all too quiet on the Easter Sunday. I said, how many glad on a resurrection Sunday? How many are glad that God got up? Oh, well, this song is a little fun, and we're going to have a little fun while we worship the Lord. So why don't you join in with us as we clap? The lyrics will be on the screen for you, so if you don't know it, it's a simple song. All it says is that he got up. Yeah, he got up so that we get up again as well.
Hallelujah. Come on, put your hands together like this. Hallelujah. Anybody glad that he got up? Oh, come on. Can I hear somebody open up your
Hallelujah.
Mouth and be thankful?
Yeah.
Hallelujah that he got up.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Yeah. Yeah. Come on, put them together.
Yeah. All right. Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Favorite part. Somebody say, you got up so I can get up again. Yeah, yeah. You got up so I can get up again. Come on, help me say it right now.
You got up, yeah, so I can get up again.
And everything's all right with you.
You got up, yeah, so I can get up again.
You got up, you got up.
You got up, so I can get up again.
We fall down, but we get up.
You got up, yeah, so I can get up again.
Say, we fall down, but we get up. That he got
up. You got up, yeah, so I can get up again.
Yeah, hey,
you got up,
yeah,
so I can get up again.
One more time, everybody say you got up, say
you got up,
so I can,
so
get,
I can
up.
Get up again.
One more time, say
you got up, so I can get up again.
You got up, you got up,
you got up.
Put your hands together.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. And be grateful.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah that he got up.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Come on, clap those hands, all ye people. I know that's a little new. It's a little different from us, right? But let me just take it to church. Living, he loved me. Dying, he saved me. Buried, he carried my sin far away. Rising, he justified me, free me forever. One day he's coming back,
glorious day.
Oh,
living, he loved me,
and if
dying, he saved me,
and if
buried, he carried
all my sins
far away.
And if
rising, he justified me, free me forever.
I know
one day he's coming back, glorious day.
Oh,
one day he's
everybody.
Praise the Lord.
Go on and praise Him, everybody.
Praise the Lord.
Before we got sophisticated with drums and organs and keyboards, we knew how to clap our hands, and we knew how to stomp our feet, and we knew how to open up our mouth. Anybody love to praise God this morning? Come on, let's just praise Him. Shout hallelujah to the Lamb of God. Come on, with everything in you, just shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Come on, you can do better. Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I know this day may sound unusual, but I'm celebrating because of what happened today. That's why we're here today. When I say here, we're only existing because of God's grace and mercy shown through His Son Jesus. And I know, is there anybody that can testify like me if it hadn't been for the blood? No. I mean, if it hadn't been for the blood. Anybody thank God for the blood? I wish I had about 15 believers that just thank God for the blood. You just thank God for the blood. 15 people that don't mind crying out and say, Lord, I thank you for your blood. I thank you for the blood. Thank you. I thank you for the blood. What my mother couldn't do, the blood did. What What my father couldn't do, the blood did. What my money couldn't do, the blood did. What my spouse couldn't do, the blood did. What the doctors couldn't do, the blood did. What the psychiatrist couldn't do, the blood did. What I couldn't do, the blood did. Woo! It was the blood. It was the blood. Somebody that understood. The blood didn't leave me where I was. I was in some mess. Okay, I got bougie people on this side. Let me talk to y'all that's real. I said I was in some mess. But the blood. Say, God has been good to me. Amen. Going to the Word of God. The Word of God will be found in the Acts according to the Apostles. Acts chapter 2, verse 22 through 24. And when you have it, just acknowledge it by standing. Acts 2, 22 through 24. God is good. It's good to see all of you in the house of worship this morning. You all look good right where you are. Here's what the word of the Lord says. It says, ye men of Israel, hear these words. Jesus of Nazareth, a man approved of God among you by miracles and wonders and signs, which God did by him in the midst of you, as ye yourselves also know. Him being delivered by the determinate counsel and foreknowledge of God,
ye have taken and by wicked hands have crucified and slain. But verse 24 is where we have the victory. Whom God have raised up, having loosed the pangs of death, because it was not possible that he should be holden of it. You may be seated. I want to speak to you very briefly from this subject. Do it for me too. Somebody say, do it for me too. For those of us who were raised in households where we had siblings, we understand so many things in life. One thing we understand when you have siblings is that if one fight, we all fight. Another thing we understand is that we can talk about each other, but can't nobody else talk about us. Am I right about it? We also learned the principle of sharing. We understand that sharing is essential in families. And then there's this one additional principle that is understood, and that is whenever a parent, a relative, or a friend would do something good or nice for one of the siblings, the other sibling expected the same thing. They would say, I want some too, or give it to me too. I'm sure many of us wanted to enjoy our own ice cream or enjoy our own trip or enjoy our own gifts all by ourselves and for ourselves. But if you have a sibling, you understand that we're all familiar with that annoying song that they would sing, do it for me too. In this morning's text, Peter is preaching about this Jesus who had been crucified not that long ago. And Peter, now being full of the Holy Ghost, is proclaiming the gospel of Jesus Christ, which was a prophecy that was given in the Old Testament that had been fulfilled in his gospel message. Peter emphasizes, he placed emphasis on Christ's sufferings. He placed emphasis on Christ's pain and Christ's death. Peter understands that this act of grace and wisdom by God was essential to repair the relationship and the breach that Adam caused in the Garden of Eden. And he enabled sin to keep the Creator and the creation separated. I want you to understand that Adam, he made it possible for Creator and the creation to be separated by this thing called sin. Peter's message, it didn't park at the sufferings and the pains and the death of Christ Jesus, but he drove his message to the powerful experience of the resurrection of Jesus Christ. It was here where Peter preaches and tells how Christ's resurrection vindicated the attack, the death, and the attack that death had on mankind, and avenged the sin of death and avenged death against Jesus Christ. And it also removed the wedge of sin that kept mankind separated from God. In fact, Jesus was approved by God not only to perform signs, not only to perform wonders, not only to perform miracles before the eyes of the people, but he was ordained and predestined to be released in the hands of the wicked. And he was ordained to be released to them so he could be illegally tried, and he could be whipped all night long, and he could be flogged, and he could be beaten, he could be spit on, he could be crowned with thorns, that he could be betrayed, he could be denied, he would be doubted. He would be made to carry a cross over 300 pounds, that he would then be crucified and he would die and then he would be buried. But it was God his Father, in whom he was obedient to, that ensured that none of these things that happened to him would win against him and or have power over him. In verse 24, our text reads, whom God have raised up, having loosed the pains of death, because it was not possible that he should be holden of it. The phrase whom God had raised up indicates that God exercised sovereignty not only in life, but even through death. And he resurrected his son Jesus from the dead and loosed him from the pains of death and released him from a sealed tomb and vindicated him against the worst enemies, which were death, hell, and the grave. Do I have a witness this morning? God did this for his only begotten son, but I also need him to do it for me too.
We have heard the song given speeches, and we've heard messages, and now we even see movies about the death, the burial, and the resurrection. And we all understand that this all happened just a number of days. But what Christ did on this journey is an actual reflection of what God can do in our lives even right now, as well as God can do with our lives in the idea of time, and even after time is over and we head to the judgment and we go into this thing called eternity. Brothers and sisters, while we are here on this side of heaven, there are a few things that we're asking God to do for us too. And just as he did for Jesus, the first thing we ask God to do is to take me through. Somebody say, take me through. Psalms 34, 17 through 19. The righteous cry and the Lord heareth and delivereth them out of all of their troubles. The Lord is nigh unto them that are of a broken heart, and saveth such as be a contrite spirit. This is one of my father's favorite scriptures. He would say, many are the afflictions of the righteous, but the Lord delivereth them out of them all. Now, one thing we know for certain, brothers and sisters, is that God did not deliver Jesus from the cross, but he delivered Jesus through the cross. God did not save Jesus from the grave, but he saved Jesus through the grave, and he raised him from the grave. Jesus himself had to go through, and he had to endure the worst of pain before he could come out victorious with all power. Now, I know we don't like to go through, but if Jesus had to go through, y'all, sometimes we have to go through. Hebrews 12, 1 through 2 says, wherefore, seeing we are also compassed about with such great a cloud of witness, let us lay aside every weight and the sin which doth easily beset us, and let us run with patience the race that is set before us, looking unto Jesus, the author and finisher of our faith, who for the joy that was set before him. Here's what he did. He endured the cross, despising the shame, and is set down at the right hand of God. Brothers and sisters, we as believers, we are not exempt from attacks. We are not exempt from being hurt. We are not exempt from harm. We're not exempt from being in anguish. We're not exempt from feeling the pain of life. We're not exempt from crying tears or even having our hearts broken. But we as believers, we understand that the only difference between us and the unbeliever is that we have and we serve a God who is able to take us through, just as he did his son Jesus. My father would often tell me that our blessings, our breakthrough, our miracles, and our deliverance are on the other side of through. But tell your neighbor, you got to go through to get to it. You've got to go through. You're not going to get to what God has if you don't go through something. In fact, if God gave you everything he had in store for you and you never went through, when you got it, you would never appreciate him. But God takes you through, so when he gives you your joy back, you remember how you was to be in sorrow. He takes you through, so when the sun begins to shine, he will remember how it was when it was raining in your life. He takes you through because when you were all alone and now you got friends, you'll never forget where your Lord has brought you from. Now, do I have a witness in here? It's on the other side of through, but that lets us know that we cannot get to them if we don't go through. Now, according to David's writing in Psalm 34 and 19, he said that many are the afflictions of the righteous. That means that there are a lot of afflictions. There's a lot of trouble. There are a lot of storms. But I came to remind you today that the Lord will deliver us out of them all. Our request then should be, just as you did Jesus, Lord, do it for me too. Take me through, because I know if God takes me through, he will also bring me out. I said, I know if God takes me through, I know God will also bring me out. And sometimes after we go through, there may be some residual pain that may be trying to linger. But as God did with Jesus, we also request, this is my second point, we should request God to loose the pain. Somebody say, loose the pain. Yes, 1 Peter 5 and 10 says, but the God of all grace, who have called us unto his eternal glory, that by Christ Jesus, after that ye have suffered a while, now he will make you perfect. He will establish you, strengthen you, and settle you. Now, if we claim the name of Christ, brothers and sisters, and if we are believers, there will be seasons of suffering. And in fact, Jesus informed us that if we want to reign with him, we have to suffer with him. But suffering is and has never been intended to be a permanent resident or a permanent tenant. Our suffering should be viewed as that unwanted family member that shows up from time to time. And although you don't want them to come, you know they got to come see you, and you let them stay until you can't take no more. Anybody got an auntie or uncle you hate to see coming around, or a cousin or a brother, but you know they family, so you got to put up with them just for a little while? That's how suffering and trials should be. You should not expect to suffer always. Reverend Timothy Wright said, I'm so glad that trouble don't last always. And so suffering should be viewed like that. Peter preaches here that after years of suffering of a little while, God will make you perfect, meaning he will make you whole. He will establish you. He will get you all together, and he will strengthen you. He will give you strength to keep going, and then he will settle you. And some of us are unsettled because we haven't suffered a little while. Now, I was told by some of the old saints that a cart that makes the most noise is the empty cart. But a cart that's weighted, you don't hear much out of them, because they understand that trouble ain't gonna last always. We must understand that pain tries to linger even after the storm is over. But just as God loosed the pains of death from his son, we're being adopted into the royal family. We can go to our Father and ask our Father to loose us from the pains that constantly plague our lives. What pains are you referring to, Brother Preacher? Well, I'm glad you ask. The physical pain that includes all manner of sickness and diseases. The emotional pains that include the worst of our heartbreaks, our disappointments, and our discouragement. Our mental pain that includes anxiety, stress, and anguish. And then our spiritual pain that includes brokenness, hopelessness, and then unforgiveness. These pains, brothers and sisters, they show up to try and to be rid free residents for a lifetime. They try to live in your life for free forever. But on this day, today, this Resurrection Sunday, we're talking to a God, and we're asking God to do it for us just as he did for his son Jesus. The pains of life and the pains of death and strengthens us. They come, they strengthen us so that finally we get to the last point. Then God can raise us up. Somebody say, raise me up. Acts chapter 10, verse 39 through 41. And we are witnesses of all things which he did both in the land and of the Jews and in Jerusalem, whom they slew and hanged on a tree. Him God raised up the third day and showed him openly, not to all people, but unto witnesses chosen before God, even to us who did eat and drink with him after he rose from the dead. Paul writes that God raised Jesus from the dead the third day, and he showed the resurrected Jesus to those who were witnesses. And all of us can say that we've been in, or that we're yet in, some dead situations. All of us can say we've been in some dead stuff. We've experienced situations in our lives that has left us feeling empty and feeling void and feeling dead on the inside. But many times we want to smile, but yet we were broken, empty, and dead on the inside. And for those of us who have been there and are no longer there, we can testify about a God that can raise us from the dead. We can testify how God brought us out of the muck and the marrow, how God picked us up, and how God turned us around. We can testify as to how God made a way out of no way. And we can tell somebody else. And then I've come for those of you who are still in some dead situations, who are still in some dead places. I've come with some good news, and that is the same God that raised Jesus from the dead is the same God that can raise you even right now. Now, the enemy loves to intimidate us and to make us believe that his attacks that he's placed on our lives are fatal and are lethal. Now, the problem with this is that it appears that the enemy has made some mistakes once before. Now, can I tell you what mistake the enemy made? Satan thought he had Jesus when Judas betrayed him. Satan thought he had Jesus when Peter denied him. Satan thought he had Jesus when they illegally tried him. Satan thought he had Jesus when they whipped him all night long. Satan thought he had Jesus when they gave him a crown of thorns on his head. Satan thought he had Jesus when they made him carry his cross. Satan thought he had Jesus when they nailed him to the cross. Mistake number two was this. After they nailed him to the cross, Satan forgot what Jesus said before he went to the cross. He said, if I be lifted up from the earth, I'll draw all men unto me. And so when he lifted him up, everybody saw the power of God that rested on the Son of God. And after lifting him up, Satan thought he was winning again. He labored on the cross. And to add to insult, he taunted Jesus with the centurion when he decided to check for life by piercing Jesus in his side. But what he didn't realize was he made a bigger mistake. He turned the water on in the washing machine, and then he put some detergent in it, because the Bible said when he pierced him in his side, blood and water came streaming out. And the songwriter said, what can wash away my sins? Nothing but the blood of Jesus. Do I have a witness in here this morning that you've been washed in the blood? And if it hadn't been for the blood, you wouldn't be clean today. But is there anybody that can tell the Lord thank you for the blood? Yeah. Satan had his greatest, after he did that, he had his greatest warriors fighting with him. And when Jesus gave up the ghost, and I'm getting ready to close right here, Satan thought his champion, death, had defeated the Son of God. And then his tag team partner, the grave, stepped in to finish the job. But Jesus, when he got off, he failed to realize that Jesus had an X factor. And the X factor Jesus had is that Jesus had a Father who was all sovereign in life and all sovereign in death. And God allowed death, hell, and the grave to win the first two rounds. But then there was round three, which was the third day morning, when Jesus got out of the grave. He got out and defeated the three amigos, death, hell, and the grave. And he raised his son Jesus up early one Sunday morning, early on that third day morning. And not only did he raise him up, but he raised him with all power in heaven and earth in his hands. And that same Jesus that was raised out of the grave is now raised in my heart and raised in every heart of every believer. And if he's raised in your heart, guess what, y'all? He's giving you power and power to be raised out of sin. He's giving you power, power to overcome the shame and guilt of your life. He's giving you power to overcome every defeated foe. He's giving you power to overcome depression in your mind. He's giving you power to overcome hopelessness in your heart. He's giving you power to overcome anguish and anxiety. Power to overcome abandonment. Power to overcome grief. Power to overcome disappointment. Power to overcome loneliness. Power to overcome sickness. Power to overcome disease. Power to overcome trauma and anything else that tries to hold you captive, and allow us not to walk in freedom. I stopped by to tell you, as I get ready to move, I came to tell you that you have access to our Heavenly Father, just as Jesus did, and just as Jesus did, I'ma say, do it for me too, Lord. I need a miracle. miracle. Lord, I need a breakthrough. Lord, I need deliverance. Lord, I need a blessing. I need a healing in my body. And I heard somebody say, ain't no failure in God. The same God that raised Jesus is the same God that can raise you. The same God that brought mama is the same God that can bring you. I'm the same yesterday, today, and forever. I'm so glad that I've got a father that I can call in heaven, and he'll send my elder brother. Jesus, my lily of the valley. Jesus, my bright and morning star. Jesus, my friend when I'm friendless. Jesus, my suffering storm. Anybody know him? He died on Calvary. He hung dead and shed his blood. But he didn't stay there. He went in the heart of the earth. But after 3 days, woo! I said after 3 days, some of you right now are on day two, but just hold on, just hold on a little while longer. Day three is coming, and when day three comes, I hear David say, weeping may endure for a night, but joy, somebody holler out joy, joy is gonna come in the morning. And the Bible says, the joy of the Lord is my strength. So I'm not afraid of what the devil tried to do, because God already defeated the devil on the cross. And if you know that the God that we serve is living on the inside of you, you got power, and you ought to give him praise. You ought to give him glory. You ought to tell him thank you. Lord, do it for me too. You did it for your son, but I need you to do it for me. You did so many great things for Jesus when he was on that cross. And you did even more things for him when you got out of the grave. But is there anybody like me that need the Lord to do it for them? I'm glad for what you did for Jesus, but I need you to do something for me. I'm broken, I'm confused, I'm lost, I'm hurt. I don't know what to do. Nobody understands me. I need you to do it for me. Because if you don't do it, it won't be done. But if you do it, it'll be done well. And I need God to do some things well in my life. I need him to do it for me. Hallelujah. I need him to do it for me. I need him to do it for me. Anybody else need him to do it for you? Hallelujah. Is there anybody here that doesn't know Jesus Christ, this Jesus that we just preached? I know everybody's going to harp on that early he got up and I said it. But I really want you to understand even more that the same God that can do it for his son can do it for us. It's good to hear the cliches, and that's all great. But when you leave here, you need to know that God can do it for you as he did it for his son. And the reason why he'll do it, because when we gave our lives to Christ, the Bible says we were adopted, meaning he changed our name and the same access and the same rights that his eldest son, Jesus, has, we now have. And if you don't know Jesus Christ, if you don't have a relationship with Jesus Christ, and if you want to be saved, if you want to receive the free gift of salvation, stand where you are. Lord, do it for me. Oh, Lord, do it for me.
it just won't be done. Oh Lord, do it. Is there anybody who want to give your life? Just stand where you are. Just stand. That's all you got to do. Lord, there you go. She's not the only one. Do it for me. Anyone else want to give your life to the Lord? There you go. There you go. Oh Lord. Stand. If you want to give your life to the Lord, stand. It's your time to receive salvation. Lord, if you don't do it, it just won't be done. So Lord, is there anybody here that you say, I'm saved, but I don't have a church home? And I think I found my church home. This is your day. Stand. If you say, I want to make this place my church home, just stand where you are. Nobody's here to make you look bad or embarrass you. Just stand. You know you need a church home, and you say, I want to be a part of this family. There you go. All right. Sister, you should be shouting. Sister Booker, you should be shouting. You should be shouting. She's been praying for this day. Come here, dear. Elder, can you grab that oil for me? The Bible said when one comes, we ought to be rejoicing. Y'all don't understand. This is her daughter. She's been praying for her daughter to come. And she's been coming. And she's been coming. And today she's making a commitment. Lord, if you don't do it, it just, she's not the only one. There's some more. Who's ready to give, make a commitment to God and make this your church home, your church family? Who's ready to make a commitment and be a part of this family? You want to be a part of this family? I want to give you space. You've been coming for a few weeks now. Your mama don't know what to do. Mama, can I tell you something? Let me tell you something else, mama. He ain't done with your son or your husband yet either. They coming in too. They coming in too. Just keep living right before them and keep loving them. Give me your first name. Gabby. Well, you know, stranger here. You've been here. All we are is a family. Ain't nobody better than nobody. They call me the pastor. I'm just a servant, okay? And from the front to the back, we all the same. Only thing that makes me different, I have more responsibility. That's it. You know what it means to be saved? Are you saved? All right, she's saved already. Well, you want to be a part of this family. Oh, I love her comment. She said, I do. She's sure about it. Well, as I said, that's it. We are brothers and sisters. And ain't nobody in here perfect. Some days, somebody may have some off days. That's all a part of our family. But we love each other here. In fact, I tell everybody, all of you ought to get the text. I say it all the time. What I put in my text? I love you to life. That's how I live by that. I love you to life. So are you willing to be a part and allow us to teach you what the Word of God says? Are you willing to be obedient to the Word of God? All right, lift your hands. Let me pray for you. Close your eyes. Put your mind on Jesus. Father God, we thank you. You've heard her confession. You even see the heart's desire. I pray, God, that as she makes this step today, that you will make things so real in her life that, God, she'll never be able to explain it, but she'll just want to get closer and closer and closer to you. I pray that you would bind the enemy now that's going to try to attack her from making this decision. Cover her in the blood, God. Keep her safe. Bind the adversary. Protect her from danger seen and unseen. And, God, wrap your loving arms around her and show yourself mighty in her life. Fill her with the Holy Ghost that she'll be endowed with power. And bind every force of evil. And, God, give her running in her feet, clapping in her hands, joy in her soul. And, God, we'll thank you and we'll praise you and we'll bless your name forever. And all of us will say amen and amen. Sister Gabby, I love you. Come on, let's praise God for our sister. Let me do this quickly, and I'm going to move out of the way. If this is your first time with us, just wave your hands. If this is your first time with us, oh, let's clap our hands, church. To each and every one of our visitors, first-time visitors, we want you to know that we understand you could have worshiped anywhere you wanted to worship this morning. But we're so appreciative that you thought of us to stop by and worship with us. And our prayer and our hope is that was something that was sang or said that was done that lifted you and drew you a little closer to the Lord. And if you don't have a church home, I just want you to know you don't have to look any further. Okay? You don't have to look no further. My dad would do something back in the day that I'm just not comfortable doing. He would walk down the aisle and he would pull your hand. He'd reach out to you and pull your hand. And I said, Dad, stop forcing people to join the church. He said, I'm not forcing them. I'm just trying to prick their heart. Well, I ain't there yet, y'all. I ain't there yet. But I do encourage you, if you're looking for a church home, you don't have to look no further. You don't have to look no further. You don't have to look no. It's so good to see you. My sister, it's good to see you. Missing you. Good to see you. Amen. Brothers, it's good to see brothers in church. All the guest brothers, the visitor brothers, just wave your hands. Man, it's good to see y'all. Y'all should be going crazy when brothers in church. Brothers, and I'm as straight as they can be, but I want you to know I love y'all. You hear me? I love y'all. God loves y'all. He wants to love, he wants to have a relationship with you. But I just want you to know, if nobody told you today, brothers, I love y'all. Amen. Encourage the brothers, man. Amen. All right, it's time to give. It's time to be blessed. I see Elder Burke's mother is in the house. Y'all wave your hand, mama. You ain't got to say nothing. Just wave your hand. That's our Elder Burke's mom right there. Amen. She's a wonderful woman. Now, she can sing and tear a tambourine up, too, now. She can sing. I'm not going to say what's happening, but the Lord is working. Amen. 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 It's time to give. It's time to give. Amen. It's time to give. It's time. How many are blessed through your tithes? How many are blessed through your tithing? I'm a witness. I'm blessed because I tithe. I'm blessed because I tithe. Here's what the Bible says as we prepare to give. Even from the days of your fathers, you have gone away from my ordinances and have not kept them. Return unto me, and I will return unto you, said the Lord of hosts. But ye said, wherein shall ye return? Will a man rob God? Yet, yeah, he have robbed me. But I say, wherein have ye robbed thee? In tithe and offering. You are cursed with the curse, for ye have robbed me, even this whole nation. Bring ye all the tithe into the storehouse, that there may be meat in mine house, and prove me now herewith, said the Lord of hosts. If I will not open you the windows of heaven and pour you out a blessing, that there shall not be room enough to receive it. And I will rebuke the devourers for your sakes, and he shall not destroy the fruit of your ground. Neither shall your vine cast her fruit before the time in the field, said the Lord of hosts. And all nations shall call you blessed, for ye shall be a delightsome land, said the Lord of hosts. As we prepare to give, we're standing with our gifts, whether it's digital or if you already given, whether it's digital or in person, stand with our gifts. We make this declaration every week. Repeat after me, I'm a tither and a giver. I am blessed beyond measure. I have more than enough. I'm living in my overflow. I'm living Ephesians 3:20 for the rest of my life. Amen. You may be seated as our finance officers are coming. If you have an in-person gift, just keep your hand lifted and they will come to you. Amen. They will come to you. Hallelujah. As they're coming, our announcements. We're still in our reading our Bible for the rest of the year. If you haven't downloaded that app, download the app. It'll give you the Bible readings to read daily, but download that app. It's free of charge in the Google Play Store or the Apple Store. It's free of charge. Download the app. If you are a member of the ministry and you want to be a part of ministry, you want a place, you know where you would like to work in ministry, we're asking you to reach out to us. We want you to start working. We want you to get engaged. We want you to be involved. All you got to do is reach out. Those are some of the positions we have, but there's a lot of things. And if there's something that you don't see that's not on there, you want to talk, let's talk about it, because the church, the ministry needs you.
The ministry needs you. We don't function without you. So if you have positions that you want to be in, please join us. Amen. Men, I just talked about us. In September is Men's Month. And I know May is coming up first. May is Women's Month. Where are all the women at? Okay. Men, I think we can beat them today. Men, where are all the men at? All right. That sounds good. That's what I'm talking about. We can meet them. We can beat them today. September is Men's Month. Men, we got an awesome, awesome things going on in the month of September. Also, we're all going to have on the same custom suit, same custom shirt, same custom tie. All you have to do is go to Torrance's House of Threads on 78th and Burleigh. Get fitted. A $50 deposit is essential. They're going to get it to fit you just right so nobody else can wear that suit. And we're going to wear that in September in Men's Month. So please do that, brothers, as soon as possible. Amen. On this Tuesday is the first Tuesday of the month. Our family forum will begin at 6 o'clock p.m. And at 7 p.m., we'll go right into our evangelism training. Our family forum, that's all of us, the men, women, and young people, will meet at 6 p.m. And then at 7 o'clock on Tuesday, we'll go right into our evangelism training. We're going to evangelize. Those text messages that I'm sending you every week to send to your family and friends, that's a part of our evangelism initiative and campaign. All you got to do is take that text, send it to three people, and invite them to come. Amen. So we're going to be teaching about that. And then this Friday, first Friday, we're going to be in our first Friday fellowship. Our evangelist, Antoinette Bent, will be our speaker, a dynamic woman of God. She's going to preach to us. On Good Friday, we had a dynamic worship service. If you weren't here, you missed a wonderful treat. We had our Elder Jackson went forth, and our evangelist Romy went forth, and we had other guest churches. We had a phenomenal time. But this Friday night will be in our first Friday night service. And then also, not this Tuesday, but the next two Tuesdays following, where all of my youth and young adults, that's up to 30 years old. If you're 30 and under, wave your hands. 30 and under, wave your hands. We have Bible, and this doesn't mean, parents, you don't come because I need you to be there. This doesn't mean that the singers, y'all get to skip out because I need you to be there. But I need everybody there. But there's an emphasis on our youth and young adults. As you all may or may not know, I'm a funeral director by profession, and I'm seeing too many of our young people die by suicide, die by overdose, die by homicide, die, you know, it's just a lot happening, and we as the church, we got to speak to this, amen? Amen, somebody. It could be your own child, your own grandchild, your own niece and nephew that could be saved. So for the next 2 weeks, that's April 9th and April 16th, we'll be in our youth and young adult worship. As I told y'all, we have a heavy emphasis on witnessing, and I'm a witness is our campaign for our evangelism all year. Everybody just say, I'm a witness. That's all you got to do. I'm a witness, and I'm going to give you the tools to do that so that we can grow the ministry and do the work of the Lord. Amen. I think that's it. We'll talk about that Sunday night revive. We'll have the fourth Sunday night. It starts in April. We're going to have some old school deliverance service every fourth Sunday night in the month of every month. That's how I say starting in April. So if you want to come and lay out on the altar, if you want to tarry for the Holy Ghost, if you want to do it, it's going to be every fourth Sunday night right here. It's going down. We have good preaching, good singing, good church. And I think that's all. We're getting ready to go home now, y'all. We got candy for our young people. Was I supposed to say that? Okay. Young people, when you leave, hear me, when you leave the church, on your way out of the door, we got candy for you on your way out. Don't go in out the door and then come back in the sanctuary. On your way out the door. And when you get home, eat as much candy as you want to. When you get home, eat as much candy as you want to. And then next week, come back and tell us all about it. Amen. Come back and tell us all about it. We're standing. We're getting ready to go home. You all look good sitting right there. I love y'all colors and all y'all pastels and florals and uniform. I see a whole family looking alike. I like that. Amen. One day I'll be able to afford some nice suits and I can wear them too. Let's pray. Gracious Father, we thank you for this awesome, wonderful worship experience. We thank you for every song sung, every prayer prayed, every speech given, all the dancing, all of the preaching, the word of God. We pray, dear Lord, that as we leave this place but never leave your presence, keep your loving arms around us and guide us to our various destinations safe and sound.
and bring us back together at the appointed time and place as we continue to recognize your resurrection. And we'll give you glory and honor in the mighty and matchless name of Jesus, we pray. Thank God. Amen. Let somebody you don't know that.